y'all, SS here. How you doing today? Today's July 1st, 2015. I want to give a shout out and a happy birthday to my best friend, my childhood friend, John Breitenbach. Happy birthday, Johnny. Also, this is being filmed on my new Fuji camera. It's not the best thing. It's $200, but it's an underwater camera. It does everything. And this is just temporary, so if it doesn't come out good, don't sweat it. We'll be upgrading other features to this program in the near future. With all that being said, today's feature is going to be eggs and bacon and Texas toast. Just something simple to get a video out there using this equipment. And like I said, if it doesn't come out professional looking, don't worry about it. It's temporary. But this video is very educational. And it's for folks that have never made eggs and bacon and Texas toast. So let's get started. Okay, what we have here is a plate or a frying pan. Apparently it has a little oil on it, so I probably need to turn the fan on or just let it burn. Let me get something. Hold on. This one's sat. No hell. There we go. Real quick. That'll be fast. I'm turning that on, no. Anyway, that's going to interfere with the audio, but
who cares, folks?
Okay. Black pepper bacon from H-E-B. Going to take some. This is good stuff, too, y'all. Not as good as Russ Jones's homemade bacon. Go check him out at Smoky Ribs on YouTube. This is it. I'm just going to make four pieces. We don't want to eat too much bacon. I cut them in half. We're just going to simply lay them on in. Like such. This seems like something super easy to do, which it is for most people. But the thing is, some people don't know how to do this. Honestly, some people don't even know how to cook, so this is probably going to help someone out there. I don't know who. Okay, we got it in there, the bacon. We have this on medium high. You're going to watch it, and it's going to start frying. You'll notice it'll start frying, and it'll start making a kind of a splashing, like a crisping up kind of sound. So look for that, okay? They're the first pieces doing it now on top. This pan is interesting. It's from, I think, Australia. I got it at Home Goods. And very, very high dollar, thick on the bottom. It can be used on induction and everything. Someone asked why haven't I been using my induction cooktop or whatever you call it. Because I have it stowed away underneath and I just don't feel like pulling it out. Still works, but I don't know. I like old school. I like to have to wait, then you get it up to temp how you like it. Then when it gets hot, you got to pick it up, you know. And I like to, keeps me kind of alert when I cook, let's say. So I'm going to let these just cook like this. You'll see they're starting to shrivel now, and they'll buckle and they'll try to lift up. You can hold it down with a spatula or something like this. Kind of hold it down. It's not going to hurt it. You know, you don't squish hamburgers and you don't squish steaks. But you sure as heck can squish bacon. It ain't going to hurt it because it's just fat, pretty much. I've turned it down a little. Now, here's a kicker. You can make your bacon crisp, or you can make your bacon semi-crisp. You gotta cook it. You gotta get it browned up at least, folks, okay? This one piece, he kind of curled a lot more than the others. I don't know why. He got a little bit. Bacon don't just happen, folks. You gotta cook it. Gotta fry it, and like I said, it seems like it's just a gimme, but it's not. And instead of using a spatula, I just use a fork. Get it started, flip it. Now, let me flip them all and I'll show you what I'm talking about. It gets to a stage, see this piece cooked weird, but it's okay. Oh, come on. I always gotta have that one that doesn't cooperate. Okay, it gets to a stage where you start seeing brown on there like that. You could turn it down just a little bit to medium. That means your pan's nice and hot, okay? Now these, today I'm not gonna go to crispy. I'm just gonna go to cooked, let's say. Cooked, okay? Because I don't wanna just crunch into it. I wanna taste the bacon. I wanna taste it. I don't wanna just taste a real crunchy, like a bacon bits type of thing, okay? It's almost there. Now we could speed this up, but we don't want to speed it up because you run into trouble that way. Okay, getting there. Once each side's cooked, you're gonna pull it out and then just throw it on a plate like this. Just throw it on a plate, and what that's gonna do is let you started on the eggs. Forgot what I was going to say. It's early, folks. Okay. I haven't even finished my coffee yet. Alright. Let me show you what we got first of all. There's our bacon. Beautiful. And you see, I don't know if you can see it, but there's fat rendered off in there right there. Do not pour that out. I repeat, do not pour that out. That is something you cannot buy at the store. Alright, we're going to take our bacon out, put it on the plate. This still cooks a little bit as it sits over there. Okay, now I have two eggs, and they're cold. If you really want to do it right, let them sit out for a while and get to room temperature, but we don't care about that because this is just a cooking show. So you make sure your fire's not too hot. You get in trouble with Bob Gilda. Crack your egg. Just like that. Put it in. And watch it cook. You don't want it too hot. You're gonna scorch it, Bob Gilda says. And this might be a little hot, so we're gonna turn it down. We're actually gonna lift it up a little. Just a little. Bob Gilda, he really warned me about. Now you ask, who's Bob Gilda? Bob Gilda is a guy from Rockport, Texas. He's known as a wade fisherman that uses artificial bait. But he does cook also. He's health food conscientious. And he really gets bent out of shape if you scorch the egg, which I'm almost there. Okay. Flip it over. I didn't scorch it, Bob. Check it out, folks. I didn't scorch it. Now we're going to do, we're not doing sunny side up. We're not doing over easy. We're doing over medium, let's say. Whatever. You do that, and then you do the same thing to the second egg. Okay. Get your plate ready. Get your egg and voila. Don't pour out all your bacon though. I mean your fat. Woo! Get back in there, boy. Let's do the other one, folks. Now that I got your attention. Crack your egg. Drop it in. Okay. This heat's a little more consistent. Not too hot. That's good. So if you get it too hot, it's hard to it's too hot, it's hard to bring it back down. And if it's too cool, it's hard to bring it up. So you want to get it in the range of frying an egg, which is start at medium high, and then go down to medium. Now this one's coming out real beautiful, but it's going to take a tiny bit longer. Now it's not symmetrical, no. It's not symmetrical, but that's all for looks, folks. You know, who cares? You're going to go back to the restaurant? I don't want to say it's not symmetrical. You're not going to do that. You're hungry. You're going to eat. All right. It's almost there. Now, you don't want to bust the yolk. You can bust it, but you don't want to bust it. Because you want that yolk to, when you cut into this egg, you want that yolk to ooze out and get on the white. The yolk will mix with the white, and it gives it a killer flavor. You can season these up now, or just wait until you put it on the plate. Whatever you want. I'm going to wait. Okay, this one looks like it's ready to flip. So I got to be very careful not to break the yolk. There we go. Hopefully I didn't break it. When you break it, you'll notice that the yellow will start seeping out. And sometimes it'll sear the hole shut and the yolk will still stay in there. Okay? So, with that being said, this one's almost done. That's done. This right here is called Texas toast. Let's get us a piece. I'm going to show you how to make some toast without turning on the oven or a toaster. These are so fat. They call it Texas toast, folks, because it's fat, you see? Put that over there. We only want one piece. Okay, this should be done now. Let's take this little guy and put him on there. Not looking nice, doesn't it? Okay. Now turn this up a little bit high. You're going to take your toast and just simply put it in there and let it get some of that bacon fat on it. Same with the other side. And you can either use butter or olive oil and get it. You're just like making a kind of like making a grilled cheese sandwich. You're just toasting the bread. I got a little bit of oil on the outside of the pan. While we're doing that, let me get up in my cupboard here. And get my get some Daigles out. This is Daigles here. Daigles Cajun grilling. To me it's a Cajun seasoning. I tasted it. It can be used on anything, so we'll put some on these eggs. Like that. Getting any results. That means we needed some butter, which I don't have any butter, but I do have olive oil, which can be just as good as butter. Get you one of these handy dandy silicone brushes, put a little bit of olive oil on the brush. Yeah, a little bit like that. I poured a whole bunch. It's all right. This will make it cook. This is part of the Greek part of the menu. That's a stupid joke. But see, it does help. It gets it to toast better. If the bread's just white, it won't really toast. Now you can push this down with a spatula to get it to toast better. There we go. I turned that up, so I'm going to turn it back down. But who wants toast that isn't toasted? That's nasty. Okay. By the way, I'm filming this on my new camera, so bear with me, folks. It's more or less an experiment, but it is a good video. Alright, there we have our little toast, okay? So we'll take the toast and get the bacon out of the way over here. Take our toast. Let's cut it. Heck with that. Let's cut it real quick. Alright, there we go. There's no need to put any butter on this or anything. Here we have it, folks. Two eggs over medium. We got some H-E-B pepper, cracked pepper bacon. We have the Texas toast has been toasted and squished down. So, without further ado, let's dig in. Okay, here we have it. Eggs, bacon, and Texas toast. Gotta love it, folks. Let me just get one of these eggs and cut it till we cut it like that. Get you some white right here. Cut the yolk. There's the yolk coming out. Get a piece of the white. Dip it in the yolk. And taste it. Perfect. The bacon. You don't eat bacon with the fork. You take the bacon and just simply put it in your mouth. Oh, this is good bacon, folks. Golly. I'm sure it's not as good as Russ Jones's, because he made it from scratch. Now you get some bread, bite it in off, move it around in the yolk, taste it. Oh, this is a good breakfast, folks. Simple. Very simple. Anyone can do it. All right. Well, thanks for watching. Thanks for all your comments. Please subscribe. My new camera doesn't have a viewfinder, so I can't look over there. I have to look straight ahead. That's just a little behind the scenes kind of a hint. Nohow, hope you enjoyed the video. Come back for the next ones. And after you're done with this video, whatever YouTube suggests, put it on autoplay and just let it go and watch some more. You never know what you're going to find. I've been doing that lately and it's super cool. You find all kinds of neat stuff. So, thanks for watching again. Please comment. Please share on all social medias. Like, thumbs up. Like if you like it. Don't like if you think it's stupid. It's cool. I don't care. And subscribe to my channel. That way when I do get around to making more videos, I'll get on a roll. Everybody who knows me, I get on a roll for a while, then I slow down, then I get on a roll. It's all according to my schedule, let's say. The way it is, folks. And that's about it. Just have a blessed weekend. Enjoy your 4th of July. Don't blow your heads off or your hands or nothing like that. You know, be careful, in other words. And remember what it's about. It's about freedom. The independence from another country, let's say, Great Britain. But it was so long ago, we don't appreciate it. We don't understand it because we were born free. Okay? And I'm guilty of that too. All right, enough of that. Love y'all. Thank you. God bless you. We'll see you next time. Adios. Hasta luego.